recording? All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome to mini session 2.5, part 2.5, whatever. Say hello to Shade, the wonderful.
Hello.
And today, we only be taking a short look at Dion's life. Let me move you, first of all, to this map. As you can see, this is just a simple map of the city. And let me show you where your folks' place is. If I grab it from the right layer. There we go. Right now, however, you are more or less over here. And I assume you're just like taking the bridges, walking around, you know, going to the place.
Dion knows probably the best route to get around.
Absolutely. You even know the places that supposed, like, you notice there are a lot of cops around. And you know how to avoid them pretty well. You have experience in the situation. However, like, once you manage to go to the Moon Islands, the first thing you notice is that there seems to be a little bit of overgrown of plants going on. What the fuck?
Well, that's rather odd, I'd say.
Yeah, there's a lot of, like, people just trying to take off some of the leaves, cops using chainsaws to chop down things that are way too big, a few trucks moving pieces around so they can get rid of it, or, I don't know, do anything with it to move it away. And you eventually, let me just, I did not prepare the map, I am not a prepared GM, gosh darn it. Give me a hot second. What do you think of the situation so far?
Dion would look over this and suddenly pull out his phone to see if anything appears differently to, well, what a stand user would normally see.
You move around and no, the plans seem normal enough, at least. You look in and out, and yeah, no, this is just many, many overgrown plants. You hear around conversation, and you notice that apparently these plants are, they came at least with the burst. People are calling the burst the whole, you know, crazy thing.
Oh, the murder sprees, not the burst?
Not just the murders, not the murder sprees, but like everything that happened in this archipelago in the hours of craziness. That's the burst. An idiot, that's why.
Look, Dion could just run on to his family on a different map.
No.
One that's prepared.
No, I literally just have to place down two icons, alright? That's the entire prep. I'm gonna cut this out of the video. I refuse to live this in. Anyway.
I'm gonna mention this at random intervals. You can't hide this.
I will cut every moment you do this out of spite, by the way.
Look, I'll post it in the chat.
Yeah, let me just. Anyway, scene name. Alright. And now I'm just gonna shove a tiny little Dion here. This corridor, and you are just walking around this mess. You eventually manage to see your actual apartment and all of that, and you walk in. You talk to the receptionist. The receptionist actually remembers you, even if the guy hasn't talked to you in a while. He lets you in, and They're here.
Dion just look around, taking it all in, considering how it's only been not even a day.
Yeah, you notice that, like, the map doesn't represent this well, but that tree that is outside is actually overgrown on the one, like, on the wall of this building, and it's, like, actually cracked this window. There's a few, like, parts of the tree growing in.
Dan would simply frown at that before continuing onwards, entering the hallway.
You knock on the door because you do not have
but,
a key to this place.
Oh, fair, yeah.
As the knock, you hear actually a rush come to the door. And opens up. And before you can say anything, the first thing you feel is an immediate hug. He hugs you tightly, 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 tightly. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. You're fine, you're fine, you're fine. Oh my god. Alright, did you get hurt? Are you alright?
I got pretty lucky during
question,
Dion, that.
What did you do with that gun? Do you have the cane on you? What do you have on you? Let me know this.
So I assume Dion probably would have dropped off the gun or, like, to someone he knows. Like, or otherwise, like, hide it for a bit.
Yeah, you, yeah.
He probably has kept, like, the cane just probably on him somewhere.
I don't think you can hide a cane.
Oh, no, definitely. It's, obvious. He hasn't purchased hiding, like,
whatever.
Stuff for it yet.
He hugs you tight. Like, oh my god, alright, you're fine. You're fine. Oh, this is okay. Have you seen your brother at all?
No, I haven't heard from him.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You see him kind of walk back in? I'm sorry to get the mood. I'm just... I don't know where he is. He hasn't responded. I remember his number, but he doesn't answer. I'm so worried. I tried to call the cops, but apparently everyone needs help, so I can't really blame them for it.
They'll show up.
I guess. Oh, this is. You see, Clementine actually she's actually on the phone right now, talking to someone. You can easily cut here real quick because of, you know, stuff. Pause here. Alright, going back in. He's like, I don't know where he is. Fuck's sake.
Where was he before it happened?
He said he was gonna go talk to a friend of his. He does this all the time, usually for study stuff, and even work sometimes. So honestly, I paid no mind. Well, no one could have predicted any of this fucking bullshit. He put his back against the wall and he's like looking up like, oh my god,
So, Diamond, I actually have a question for you.
Yeah.
How much do these two know about stands and the like?
That's a good question. Let me roll something for
free, your dad.
Let me check your stats. Ooh, that's a fun time.
Because it says here depends on us.
Favor and roll Roll your brains. When you were trained, when your father was teaching you about the mirror line stuff, at some point he told you about these dangerous thing out there called stands. They were basically ghosts that people could summon, and they were invisible, unhearable, and very hard to notice to the average person. So he always told you, if you happen to meet one of those, may causing trouble, just run away. But that's about as much as you know he knows. He doesn't seem to talk too much about us, but you know he knows. Clementine, on the other hand, you have never captured any glimpse of knowing about the stuff. She's like, yes,
so
I'm aware of everyone's help. It's my son.
And if I talk to you for a moment in the other room.
I'm gonna, let me see, 1, 2, 3, there are like 3 rooms. I'm gonna say this is your room, that since you left, it became like a guest room. So like there's this small bit of nostalgia that hits you. For the exception, of course, your stuff is not here, and also this plant is overgrown as fuck on this side of the room. Sorry, I kind of touched it. Of the other rooms first.
The understandableness is on, but I wanted to let you know at least one fact that I know about for Tyler.
What happened with him?
Don't know how much you know, but he has a stand.
Oh. He didn't tell me.
But his has a very unique property.
Mm-hmm.
As Dion going to basically pull out his phone, and I think this is the first time he's properly summoning it. As it's not visible, but Dan appears and he shows it to his father.
Actually, so this shows up in the screen phone, right?
Yes.
Yeah, he looks at it like, oh, that, okay, so, hey, Dion, funny thing, I saw that on my phone. When Josh was talking, that Josh guy, I'm a bit of a stand user.
Okay. That.
Look, come on, I'm a security guard. It's fair. I need a. I have a superpower. It helps.
I don't blame you at all. I just wanted to show you that since. It's still attached to my phone, and I can still call on it.
Wait, he's still alive, okay. That's... You seem like... okay, that's very nice.
Yeah, that's the first thing I checked once things cleared up a bit.
By the way, Dion, you only managed to notice it now. But your father, let me find it real quick. Which one is this? I haven't decided on it yet. Let me see if I wrote down if he's left-handed or not. I'm gonna say it's his right arm. You notice, actually. His right arm, you notice that on the hug, he kind of didn't hug you very well. There was something weird underneath the suit covering his right arm.
What happened to your arm, if you don't mind me asking?
That was a bit, fucking, yeah, that, my head is kind of not with many memories of the burst exactly, but, I already showed you Clementine, she managed to stabilize it, and, he shows, and he kind of pulls the sleeve, like, the right arm of your dad is fucked up by like a roots of trees. Like it's kind of mangled and filled with like trees holes into his arm. It's very ugly, even if it's not bleeding at all. It's ugh.
So, okay. At least you're alive. It doesn't look.
Yeah, I would go.
This is the best.
I called a hospital, but apparently even the hospital got highly damaged during this. Luckily, of course, Clementine was here, and even if she's not a medic, she has some experience on the field because of her family, and she managed to make the worst stop. But I'm gonna be honest, I'm gonna have to cut this off, the entire thing. Yeah,
I
I'll be
can see.
fine. Yeah, I'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
Chirpa stand user, I actually wanted to ask you one thing because I heard a term that came up recently.
Oh, what's up?
Empathy in relation to stand users?
You see me think about it a little bit. Empathy, empathy, empathy. Can't quite put my finger on it. He let me roll a thing for him. 1d6 plus 3, and I'm gonna roll Destiny to see if he knows a piece of information or not. I've heard some stuff about it. I don't know exactly how it works. I know there's this name attached to empathy a little bit. I think its name is like, it's like ho. Give me 1 second. He pulls out his phone. It's in Spanish, I think. And Roberto Carlos, written like this. I think it's a dude that knows a lot about it. I don't know exactly who he is, though. I'm not gonna lie, I think he's attached to the mafia. Which, you know, it's a bad thing, so
Yeah,
I don't really recommend you go after this guy.
the reason I ask is I learned one fact about it that was interesting. Only a stand user can possess empathy.
Yeah, that fits up with the rumors that I heard.
But I apparently possess empathy without a stand.
What the fuck? How? Wait, you don't know about it. That's what you're asking. What? I'm stupid. Yeah, no, that is. I'm sorry, I don't exactly know about that.
I assumed it was something related to Miraline, but if that's the case, then no.
Well, I've already tried it, and Miraline can, when you do the clones, it can have your stand. Basically, you know, a mirror of you has your stand. However, I don't think it has anything to do with empathy, or anything at all related to whatever is happening to you, honestly.
I thought maybe it ran in our family or something.
Where,
Just.
out of curiosity, where did you run into this empathy term?
Well, I, to my understanding, ran into another user of it.
So, do I know this person?
I don't think you would.
Yeah, it's fine. Did you get too hurt? I mean, you look okay. You could get fucked, actually. Looks like you got ran by a trolley cart.
So funny story about that.
What?
I was on a trolley cart. However, the oddest thing happened. You know how everyone kept it going for a while with the event? Sort of stopped on me and a few others that were around the area.
Do you think that's like your empathy thing protecting you guys?
Possibly. Again, I'm still trying to piece it together.
I mean, I wouldn't doubt it. I am 90% sure this happened because of a stand ability. So maybe these empathy makes you strong enough to not be affected by it, even if it's just a little bit of it. I don't know. This is a guess.
Best guess, or a better guess than I've got.
What was your guess? And I want to hear it.
Well, to be fair, I didn't want to assume it was empathy because I do not know the limits of empathy.
That is very fair.
I'd rather not make it a habit of lumping random events or effects.
Oh, yeah, by the way, I didn't ask about it because, again, I was asking about your brother. A little bit more calm now. What's up with the cane?
Well, I think the best way to put it is it is a stand that I had found.
Oh. So, like, you can just use it around without being yours? Oh, that's neat.
Dion's going to pull it out and then unsheath it.
Good metal.
It's got its own properties, and not really sure whatever was called, I'm digging into mentally calling it catalyst.
Catalyst. That's a good name, honestly. Well, at least for something that's not even yours.
Oh.
Yeah.
But
By
it's
the way, how did you get it?
it was on the trolley.
Why was it on the trolley?
I'm not sure. I kind of just felt it calling out during that, and you know how it was during the event where you're not exactly in the right mindset. It's a little bit blurry at that point.
Dion, what was the job you got again?
I was working delivery.
Delivery. I know this was all chaotic as fuck, but you don't have a stand. But then you got a stand sheathed in your hands right now. Like, it's not your stand. How do you know it's not your stand?
Because I. So you remember how I was with other people?
Yeah.
I still couldn't see their stands.
It's too much of a coincidence for that to be there.
I mean, fate is an odd thing sometimes.
I'm gonna be honest, I think you're hiding something from me. Which is fair, Like, I was hiding the whole stand thing, but that was because I was trying to, you know, not let you into this fight, into this whole stand bullshit. It's all bullshit and dangerous. But, like, you're
I've
clearly on it.
put that together.
Yeah, you're clearly on the stuff. And I'm worried about you, Dion. Do you generally not know why Dad was there?
I have some idea of it.
Can you tell me why? What it is?
Someone, to my understanding, someone was looking to buy it. That I was just acting as the delivery person.
That is a very dangerous job you just got into. You know that, right?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Dion, just find a way to sell that sword. It's not ideal to have that.
I'll see what I can do with it.
Yeah. Yeah. You see him kind of cross his arms a bit, like, and he closes his eyes. Fucking hell. You ever need me, alright, if you're in help, if you're in a pickle, if you need me to kill someone, alright, I'm telling you this straight up, I will do it, alright, one of the most precious things I have in this world, and I'm not gonna let anything hurt you, alright. Well, kill you, I guess. You already got hurt. Kind of already screwed up on that part.
Dion sort of pauses at this, just sort of taking this in as a bit of a different side than his dad normally shows. Oh, I'll keep in mind. But right now, there's a lot going on in this city. You and I can see that from the position of a nobody.
Yeah. If what Josh said is right, everything's gonna be very more dangerous now. I already called up on my boss and talked to him about the situation, and actually, I talked to him and he said that he would actually help me out find a cybernetic arm thing.
Oh. Look, I'm sure that'd make Tyler happy to see that you're getting some use out of his work once he sees you again.
Oh, yeah, no, I don't think I told you. The company I'm actually being security of is the company he works in. Tyler managed to get a good word for me, and I got a job there.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, no, great. And, well, I guess I'll have to work a little bit harder because I'll get the closest thing to free as this gets. But still, yeah.
Nothing's ever free in this world.
Yeah, yeah. Dion, your phone starts calling, by the way.
Mind if I step out and take this?
Actually, I'm gonna step out because I'm gonna check on Clementine. You stay in, and he closes the door behind him before, you know, moving over here.
Ian slowly, like, looks over the number, tries to recognize it as he takes a seat on what I presume is half the bed that hasn't been overgrown.
Exactly. You don't recognize this number. However, you, let me find the correct image because I don't. You actually recognize this voice if I fucking find it. It's Tyler's voice. It's Tyler's voice. So you're here, Tyler. Hey, Dion.
Hey.
Good news, I'm not bleeding out anymore. I'm all right. I'm also kind of calling you secretly because no one wanted me to do that because they want to keep the place I'm in a secret, which is fair. But you gotta know I'm all right. I'm also gonna call Dad real soon about it.
I'm actually over by them if you want to just
Yeah,
need to go grab them.
also, also mom, but actually, no, my situation is kind of weird. I don't want mom. It kind of includes stand bullshit and some other weird stuff that is not stand, but it's also bullshit. Sorry to swears.
I'll throw money in the jar for you.
Thank you. go call Dad real quick.
And keep the phone like half a peek outside and just kind of wave at like his father back in.
Okay, one second. All right, look, just go do something, right? Yeah, I know. She goes sits down,
Before Andrew gets here, though, Dan's gonna step back in and just like, can you say where you are or no?
I want to, but I feel like you'd get killed if you got here. You and Dad both. Like, they don't want to kill me. They're actually very nice to me. They're trying to help me out a lot. But I can't leave. I mean, I can, just. This is a very awkward situation. At that
Okay.
point, Andrew comes inside. Yes, Dion.
Dion's going to put on speaker.
Hi, Dad. Oh my God. He kind of gets close to the phone, even though there's no, it's not a video call. We're gonna be all right. Yeah, I'm all right. Look, I'm fine. Thank goodness. I mean, where are you? I'm going to pick you up. I can't leave the place I'm in for reasons I might not anyone else is forcing me to say this. I myself don't want to say it. I'm alive and well, though. You guys can call me at any moment, and with this new number I got, I can call you guys at any moment. I mean, actually, don't call me at any moment, cause I don't want anyone knowing I have a new phone. But you know, I can call you guys, and all that. And Andrew's like, "Well, what? Look, I don't care. Where are you? I just make sure you're right. Look, I am fine." Dion, tell him I'm fine or something, please. It's awkward. Andrew is looking at you, Dion, like with the face of like, fucking help me find where he is.
So Dion's going to consider something for a moment. I assume I cannot use empathy at this distance with Tyler.
Technically, with the stand that is attached to you, and let's say you tried it before, you just hear your own thoughts better.
Fair enough. Just figured I'd look. Just you're safe, right?
Oh, yeah, no, 100% safe.
When do you think you'll be allowed to leave?
You hear a few, little bit of background noise. Okay, I'm fine. On the worst case scenario, never, which is, well, everyone here is a little bit pessimistic about my current situation, so that's seeming like the option. And it's like, no, we're gonna get you out. Now, look, there is some ideas they have, the people here, and there are some stuff they're gonna try to figure out, so maybe they don't actually know when they would be able to do it, so like, it's either never or at a random moment.
So, you don't sound as fine as you make it out to be for
Well,
that
I
wording.
mean, they have food. I can play some games with some people here. They're all very nice, very understanding my situation. Even the guys that quote unquote kidnapped me, like, they really didn't want to do it, but also when they explained what happened to me, like, I can't really deny what's happening. Had a bit of an existential crisis, but I'm better now. Look, I don't want this to be the thing happening to us right now, but I'm fine. I'm gonna keep you guys updated. I'm gonna call it like once a week, every Saturday. And yeah.
Please do.
I will.
And I hope you understand when I say this, and I know the same for her father. They're still gonna try to find you.
Don't do that. They're like fifth, like, they're like, to be fair, they're like two stand users here, I think. And both of them can kick ass. There's also a big ass fucking werewolf. By the way, werewolves are re- Why did I shouldn't have said that. Fuck. I ignored the last part.
Of course.
Yeah, look, werewolves are real. There's a big ass fucking werewolf, and apparently he has depression.
Fair enough.
Yeah, apparently he also showed up here right after the burst. The guy that helped me out found him and brought him here, and much like me, he's stuck here too because of his weird situation. No, I'm not a werewolf, by the way. I checked. That's 100% what's not happening with me.
So, I want to ask one last thing. Is it that you don't want to leave or that they are preventing you?
They are, and also it's a weird situation. Like, how can I put this? They like, there's like a few people that don't want to let me leave, but like the leader guys, I guess. They're like, look, you can leave, but like, you're gonna fucking die. And you know, knowing what they told me, I can't argue with that. I cannot argue, and I will not, you know, I'm not feeling like trying to leave exactly at the moment. Maybe at some point.
Okay, that tells me enough.
Oh, by the way, you know, I'm gonna tell you this much. Do you guys know the whiiiiile? And the standard, like, I mean, yeah, they are the big hospital chain thing. I also know they have very unique plants to use for medicinal uses for remedies and whatever. Well, so they're fucked up and evil, like the dictionary version of fucked up and evil. Very fucked up and evil, like very evil. I mean, they didn't do anything to me, but I know they're fucked up and evil. And like, few people here are very fucked up because of the evil.
Do you think any of them could make large amounts of plants grow?
He looks around a little bit. There's like that this one lady who does a little sparkly thing, but like it's not as much as this. I mean, to be fair, look, I kept up with the news. That's apparently just the entire plant life of the Moon Island just decided to grow. I don't think it's related to her abilities. I'm not even sure if she's a stand user.
That's fair. I figured if any group for what you described, it might be them.
No, it's definitely not them. It's definitely not this group of weird people. Yeah, that's about it.
All I can say is stay safe, or don't do anything stupid.
Yeah, I won't be doing anything stupid. By the way, I feel like, no, actually I shouldn't say this, you guys are gonna find me then. Yeah, that's about it. By the way, Dad, can you leave me alone with Dion real quick? I wanna tell him something that I don't wanna tell you about it. No offense. And just feel like, what the? This is literally not the moment for that.
Dion's going to take it off Seeker and put his ear real quick.
Fine. He walks out and closes the door.
Dion's gonna walk slightly into the, towards the overgrowth, knowing that father has a decent chance of trying to listen in.
Puts ear on door. you hear me like, so I kinda help Josh, like, do the whole, you know, technology thing where everyone could hear, you know, his video thing. You know, Josh, the big guy.
That's why saying if you leave, you'll be in danger.
Oh, no, that's not it at all, actually. I don't think anyone could give more of a shit about me. I just helped him do the filming. I didn't do anything else. He didn't even tell me what he was gonna do. He just said he needed this. And then he gave me a vaccine. I took it when the time arose, and... Oh boy, that was a lot of adrenaline.
So a vaccine? Did you not?
There was a syringe, and Josh has been helping out a ton. Like, the reason why I had such a good job is because he helped me out. Actually, one day it was like being attacked by a bunch of muggers or whatever, thieves, and I used my stand, and he actually was after them. When he saw what I did, he actually talked to me, and he was super nice.
I'd say probably not to get involved with him, but that's far too late.
But another side note, the vaccine thing, apparently the main producers of this drug are the Wicapeepos, which makes them extra dangerous. You know, bunch of fucked up and evil people doing fucked up and evil shit under fucked up and evil hospital to many, many people. Oh, also, they have their most powerful stand drug bullshit going on. It's very fucked up.
I'd like to ask at least one thing from you.
Yeah.
Do you know what happened to that island? The one that's shattered?
He needed to do a very cool message to the entire island, and he couldn't do it without me. I couldn't see no no, he helped me out so much, get the job, get some nice things, stuff like that. And I did. If there's one person who definitely knows about it, it's gotta be him. If he's even alive anymore. Wait, give me a hot second. He actually turns off the phone, and he waited like a yeah, he turns off the phone.
Theon's gonna wait like 2 minutes.
Exactly 1 minute and a few seconds later. Okay, so there are apparently ghosts. They don't really talk to people. So like I was gonna see if we could find a ghost or something. Because you know, stands are basically ghosts, but what about actual ghosts if they exist and all that? And apparently ghosts just aren't talkative, so like you can't really talk to the dead to ask about Josh, I suppose. Yeah, sorry, I just got really curious about it.
No, you're all good, I guess.
Do you need to find any piece of information right now? I can still help you up, help you out of that.
The one I'd ask, but this is also a bit of a weird look, is empathy.
Oh yeah, Josh told me all about it. I mean, I think I actually still have it in my old. They took all my ships, so I couldn't talk to people, but I think I still had it on my phone. Although I like to write things down on my phone. Let me see if I can find it. Empathy, empathy, empathy. Okay. Empathy. Stand users sometimes live their entire lives with their capabilities on the minimum, but in some rare cases, they decided to learn how to use their power better. And a Brazilian named Roberto Carlos Veloso, I think that's how it's pronounced, was known for having basically mastered this and named it empatia, or empathy in English. Apparently, if you have a stand, you can make your stand like grab a shovel and make the shovel be able to touch stands and slap another stand with the shovel.
That's an interesting use for that.
Yeah. According here, one of the strongest uses of it was apparently someone making an entire buzz stand touchy. And he just ran over in a very big stand. That's one of the stories that he told me about the use of it. This Roberto Carlos guy, he is actually one of the strongest stand users around. And he's actually one of the many, many important people that like knows things and like is very powerful and strong and all of that.
You happen to know where he is?
I mean, honestly, from what I know from the guy, from what Josh told me, the guy likes like having this weird like quote unquote poor person lifestyle. Like, lives actually teaching kids to steal wallets, and he helps out people that are poor and hangs out in like small little bars. And honestly, if I you just wait like a day or two, and there should be like a new little gang trying to take over that is probably controlled by him. He probably wants to try and keep the entire archipelago secure to, you know, not make sure everything goes to shit. This Roberto guy seems pretty nice on that regard, I suppose.
So I'm sorry, it's just something came up with empathy, so I was curious about it.
you get a stand?
Well, halfway.
How does that even work?
I found it.
You found, let me guess, is this like one of, is it an item or something? I mean, how would you even be able to use the ability without being the user?
And this is something I don't want you to tell the people around you.
Oh no, I'm completely alone right now.
Well, for some reason I can.
Oh, holy shit.
More importantly, apparently I have, like, a, from what I understand, another empathy user, well, recognize me as one. So I'm trying to figure out why I have it.
Can I do a crackpot theory?
Go for it.
Your stand ran away from you.
You know, knowing my luck, that's believable.
Yeah, but the jokes aside, that's honestly sound viable considering how weird these things can get.
I just mean, it wouldn't explain, like, the only thing that makes me doubt that is not being able to see stands.
It stole your stand eyes as well, before leaving.
Well, I mean, fair enough, I guess, yes, it could pick up pretty good theory.
Thank you. And once I'm right about it, you can tell me. Like, yeah, no, you were totally right, Tyler. Yeah. Oh, one more thing. I'm not gonna participate in it because, well, I'm not strong at all. I mean, I have a stand, but I still don't wanna do bullshit with it. I still don't wanna hurt people with it, you know, myself. Besides for self-defense. But I think the people around here, they're gonna get into the gang wars. I think they want to start taking territory to try and kill the Wicca peoples.
So, Diamond, mind if I make a brain check to see, or like, don't know, I don't remember this, at least for which, like, area they specifically operate out of?
The Wicca peoples. Yeah, let me take a map again, just for reference. Let me load the map again on the camera, there we go. So, for reference, the Wicca peoples, they're hospitals. There's like a hospital, like, I'm gonna make like little yellow thingies on the map. There's a hospital like here. There is one like here, right in the middle. However, they have a huge this is the biggest hospital in the world, by the way. It's like the biggest thing ever on the northeast. There's another one here. There's another one here and here and here. There's definitely one here. Definitely one like over here. And there's definitely one over here. And besides the hospitals themselves, they do have some like greenhouses like spread all over the Moon Islands. Like even on their way here, you could have noticed a few greenhouses that were overflowing with plants and stuff.
Okay, so they're after that group, or like, so they really got a grudge against those people.
Well, they are fucked up people, honestly. They deserve it. They have it coming for them. If you see a Wicca people, smack them. They deserve it.
Oh. Do you think they're gonna go after the random hospitals, or one of their bigger ones?
Probably first the green houses. Well, they're probably first gonna take a territory to start, probably the one we are in, and then After that, they're gonna go for the island that we currently are in, then they're gonna spread around slowly. I don't think they have the way to just like speed run, go to the big hospital and fuck the weaker peoples up. I think they want to weaken them as much as they can.
That's fair enough, though. I imagine they're probably gonna start pretty small then, at least in the islands.
Small is a word to use to define it. This entire situation is on a big scale. Everything going on is on a big scale. It's an entire archipelago going to shit. Sorry for the swear.
You're really running my wallet today, you know?
Shut up.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Like, as long as you're safe.
Yeah, no, I'm totally safe. The worst that could happen to me is that there are a few people here that are very, very nice, and I might just lend my stand to them just so they can be extra safe. But besides of that, it won't even transfer damage to me, only to them, so I'll be safe no matter what. I can promise that.
I'd probably say try to avoid that just because you don't want to connect yourself too much to them and
Yeah,
depending on how things go.
that's why I said maybe I'll do it. I'm not fully on planning on doing that. You know? It's kind of like if they really need it, if they're about to die.
That's fair. I can understand that feeling. You did mention there's only like two proper stand users.
Yeah, they're only two proper. To be fair, there aren't that many stand users. Like, the archipelago is big, but there aren't that many stand users when you really come to think of it.
I'm gonna be honest with you, Tyler. I've run into six today.
What the fuck?
I've had a day.
Jesus! You're not even stand user yourself. Hell. Who are they? Can I know them?
They're pretty friendly people. Maybe I'll let you meet them once you come home.
Hopefully I will. Oh, do
But,
we even want to talk about anything else? Because I don't got much going on after this.
I think I should probably go back to Dad.
I'm gonna. Can you pass me his phone number? I didn't memorize that one. Ugh. No one expects you to have to memorize phone numbers. They're saved for a reason. The fact that I eventually remembered yours was actually kind of lucky.
Fair, yeah. Dion would list it off as he has his family's phone numbers memorized.
Yeah, Dion is capable. Okay, good. I'm gonna call Dad in a few minutes so I can keep talking to him. And yeah, I'm actually changed my I might actually just ask him to lend the phone to Mom. I'm feeling a little bit bad about leaving her completely out of the light.
Help her calm down a little bit. She's
Yeah,
worried.
it's really shitty.
Last I saw, she's been on the phone with the police for who knows how long.
Oh god, so bad. Oh,
You want Mom's phone number as well?
yeah, 100%.
Once again, Dion will give the number.
Yeah. Well, I guess see you later, or do you have any other question you have?
This talk to you soon.
Love you.
Love you too. The moment Dion like does it, he seems to just relax from being almost a bit tense during it, just out of concern. Before a moment, just moving over, opening the door, and
Yeah, actually, when I open the door, your dad is kind of like calming. phone with the police, screaming a bit, not really screaming, but being a little bit, you're alright, right?
Yeah, from what I saw when I was walking over here, they've got their best out and about that.
Oh my god,
just trying to help around.
You got some cuts on you.
And I was,
You have a quick flashback to a trolley car crash.
Yeah, I was in, was in not the best place when,
Come on, this is partly, let me, the sympathize? Is that the English word? Ask the GM.
What is it?
The sympathize, it's like, take away the...
Synthesize?
Take away the dirt from it, because it's bad for it to be in touch with your blood.
Sanitize?
Yeah, sanitize, whatever. Sanitize it.
Disinfect.
Disinfected. Thank you. I love you, by the way. yeah, let me disinfect this rope. Come on, Dion. And should we take you to your place?
I will say, just like while Dion's falling behind, he'll nod over to Andrew, or like his father.
Yeah.
Tyler's gonna be calling you and mom soon. It'd be nice if you brew me a cup. I'd gotta go, you with us first.
You see her actually bringing a little med kit that she has. So, do you remember how it got this one, or is it a blur because of the burst?
I was on a trolley during when it started. There was other passengers, so it was bound to happen.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. She starts like applying some things to your cuts. It burns a little bit, but you're a big boy. I feel like you of all the players would be able to withstand the pain of this.
Look, Theon's been through a lot in these last 24 hours.
Yeah. It's like, I was mostly very lucky, and apparently my voice is better now, but from what I could gather, I just spent the entire first time screaming. It was pretty bad about a few hours ago.
Well, the comforting thing is at least that things are getting cleaned up from it. People are working their hardest to get things back to normal as soon as possible.
Yeah. It's 100% the politicians wanting their fucking money. They don't actually care, honestly.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, whatever.
But if their greediness leads to benefit, I've got no complaints.
Yeah, that is fair. I'm a little bit... It's gonna be annoying, but me and Orgetta are actually gonna spend, well, after we saw his arm off in the hospital.
Yeah, he showed me that.
No, that's looking awful. I'm honestly surprised I managed to make that stop being worse, but it's gonna be the first thing we do once things get a little bit better. Tomorrow morning we're leaving. Oh, by the way, you 100% should sleep here. You seem absolutely tired.
Yeah, it's been a bit of a chaotic day just ever since the start of it.
Yeah, you should sleep at your brother's room. Your room is a little bit, green right now.
And here I was thinking I need to take a buzzsaw to it.
I'm a little bit religious, but man, God's angry, I guess.
I mean, I've heard, like, chat at least at one point that, some people think this island is alive. Like this chain of islands.
I mean, I've heard of this island used to be alive, and it's not anymore. I mean,
Perhaps
that's my
instead of
theory.
God, it might be the islands that we live on.
Ooh, I'm gonna grow on your house. That's the
I
island right
mean,
there.
Dion kind of nods towards his room through the wall. It's just like, I think it tried that.
And it kind of succeeded and kind of failed. There's a lot of buildings still kind of well. And do you plan
And
to do anything else, Dion?
I think the only thing he'd try, like just relaxing, is pointing empathy at the sword to see if that has anything or can give any info on it.
So, you can move yourself to Tyler's room just for the sake of not being, weird
I
or,
assume.
yeah, you can just like be over here, boom, teleport. You have a cup of coffee as well, and it's like 1 a.m. right now, fucking hell, and you grab your sword, and you take a breath in. You try to remember how it felt. You concentrate on it. What is this sword feeling? Right now, the sword? Is it really the sword? Well, the sword seems to be angry and in a lot of pain.
Can Dion tell if it's like pointed at anything in specific?
The sword is not moving whatsoever. Unless you move it. Move your hand, because you have those.
Oh, more so it's anger direct, like is being directed
It
at anything.
seems to be angry at everything? It's not really that, but it's also kind of that.
Well, seems you don't like the things the way things are. Well, let's change them, shall we? Dion kind of says to nobody, just kind of holding, like looking over the sword. What?
You hear that, by the way.
From where?
You don't know. Didn't come from the sword.
Yeah, it's just going to look around and see. Oh. And who might you be? Too tired to really get an energetic response at this point.
There is no response. Whatsoever, it's zero, it's nothing. What you do remember is that, hey, remember what happened to your shadow? That's technically still there, as far as you know.
Maybe it's just the dog, I guess.
Yes, the dog laughed like a gremlin.
Look, Dion doesn't. I'm considering it's 1 a.m. Dion was not tired enough to think that he would not hear it laughing, even if it was laughing.
Yeah. Do you want to try empathy on the dog?
Sure. Let's go.
You concentrate. You try to listen to it. These vibes, these feelings. seems to be contempt. Yet very noting of what's happening. Like, your attention is on like 70%, but it's satisfied with what's happening right now.
And this thing that Dion is just going to sheath the sword and then start getting ready for sleep.
Very late, and you go to sleep. It's honestly not much else you want to do, and you close your eyes, and it's freaking finally rest. The day was long, very long. I wonder what is going on with me. What is all of this? Is it gonna get any worse? Any better? Is it gonna get any weirder? Probably. But honestly, of all things, it could get a lot more fun. And that's the mini session of Twister Throne for Shade.
Woo! Oh!
Woo!
I'm scared.
You should be. Today was a session. Huh.
It basically was.
It basically was.
Yeah?
What do you guys think?
That was good.
That was supposed to be a mini session, by the way.
Look, Dion just had family members interact with.
Yeah. I kinda gotta go, cause shit's happening.
Alright.
See y'all later.